In the beginning of this year, I made a promise to myself to print more of my photos. As much as I enjoy seeing my work on paper, I never really dedicated the time and energy it deserves. I would print some photos probably once a year, if not less, and that was about it. A couple of times I went through the process of creating a small book slash album, which although it took me quite a lot of time to produce, ultimately was very satisfying to flip through and keep on my bookshelf. Even with that, printing has always been a very small part of my photography. This year I wanted to change that. And since darkroom printing was something I always missed ever since I got introduced to it more than 10 years ago, I thought it would be a great opportunity to practice in a darkroom and print more of my photos. 5 months in and I'm having loads of fun, there is just so much to learn and experiment on that makes it really exciting. One thing that got me interested was to see how cinema films would respond when printed. And since I now have access to a darkroom, I thought it would be a great excuse for a part 2 video comparing prints from the two rolls I shot on my last video, one developed in C41 and the other in ECN2, and see how they compare when printed. In my previous video I was comparing how the two different processes affect a film when the end goal is to digitize it, and found some very interesting results when the two films ended up looking very similar when scanned. But let's see how they look like when printed. Let's start this one by having a closer look at the negatives. These are all from the images you are going to see printed later in the video. At the end I threw in a negative from a roll of Portra 400 just for comparison, since I think this film is a good benchmark for most people. Do you see the recurring theme here? The one developed in ECN2 chemistry looks much flatter than the one developed in C41, which looks much more contrasting. But this is something that never translated in the digitized images. My guess is that since there is so much information on the negative, and with the modern software being so capable, it makes it very easy to extract the most out of the film and end up with similar looking images. If my theory is correct, then darkroom printing should probably reveal the inherent contrast difference of the two processes, as there is much less contrast control when printing color film in RA4 chemistry. Before we have a look at the prints, let's see how this test was conducted so you can judge the results better. All the prints you are about to see are straight prints, meaning there are no local adjustments, no dodging, no burning, nothing. The paper I used is the Fuji Crystal Archive II, on glossy finish and 8x10 inches in size. I used the DeVere enlarger and the prints were developed in an automated processor with RA4 chemistry. At the end, the prints were scanned by a lab using an EPSON V800 and the tiff files were slightly adjusted to make sure that they match the real life prints as closely as possible. If you need the full information on filtration and exposure times, have a look at my blog post where I listed everything. The link is in the description of this video. Also, if you need any information on how the first part of the test was conducted, including how these rolls were exposed and developed, then have a look at the first video, which you can also find down below. Now on to the results. Alright. So I'm going to be looking at the monitor as well as the actual prints that I have here, and actually I'm going to start with the still life shot. So let me bring that up. I'm going to start with the C41 version first, and yeah, here you're looking at the C41, and this was a quick setup I did back then, but it works well. I think it's a balanced image, it's nicely lit, and it makes for a good base comparison. So that's why I want to start it with this one. And I think the blue background looks a tad more purplish than real life. It has a bit more magenta, a bit more blue than it should. The fabric under the product looks a bit more yellow. And one reason actually I started with this image is because I own all the props that are in it, so I could reference them and see how they differ from real life. The bottle and the liquid are looking pretty good overall, I would say. Contrast looks to be right at the very top I would like it to be. If this was a digital scan, I would probably back it off a little.
And now let's switch to the ECN-2 file. Let me bring that up. Yeah, and here we can finally see a considerable difference between the two. I think what was evident in the negatives but never really translated in the scans on the previous video, I think can finally be seen here. Color-wise, the background looks like it has a bit more green and a bit more cyan compared to real life. Same goes, I think, for the tablecloth. But the biggest difference that you can see right away is the contrast, or the lack thereof. The image appears flatter, but I would say it has a more natural look to it. Let's put them side by side and see the differences. Okay, I'm gonna keep the ECN2 on the left side and the C41 on the right side. Yeah, I think the ECN2 print has something natural about it, which I like. Ideally, would love something in between, not as contrasty as the C41 and not that flat as the ECN2. And in general, contrast tweaking in RE4 printing is not something you can easily control. Anyone who has played with black and white printing knows that you can pretty much do anything with contrast, anything you want. Like, you can go as low or as high as you wish, but the same doesn't really apply with RE4 printing. And there are some ways and some techniques that you can manipulate contrast. You can increase or decrease it, but it's not that straightforward, and you don't have that level of control as you do in black and white. And as for the colors, I think a skilled darkroom technician would probably be able to get a better match between the two images if they had to, but for the purpose of this video, I think these straight prints serve us well enough to visualize the main differences between ECN2 and C41 processed cinema film. Now let's move to the second image, and let me bring that up. So I'm gonna open up both for you. Left is the ECN2 and right is the C41. So this image was taken late in the afternoon. The sun was quite low, hitting at an angle into the house, hitting these plants. It was quite a warm, sunny afternoon. And once again, we see, I think, the main difference between the two, which is the contrast. C41 being more punchy and ECN2 appearing more natural, less intense. And by the way, there are important reasons as to why a movie production would need to have a flatter negative after filming, but I don't want to get into that. I'm interested to compare the film from a still photographer's standpoint, and since the whole wrist pulling thing has boomed the last few years, I think there are plenty of people who can find comparisons like this very useful. Now on this image, the colors appear to be a little bit closer between the two of them. I think the ECN2 has a bit bluish shadows, but yeah, again, the main difference I can see is contrast. That's the more pronounced one. And possibly the highlights on the C41 are a bit more warmer, but this could be a fault on my end as well. Maybe a better technician could match the two. So yeah, I think the main difference is, again, the contrast. And let's move to another image. Now, this set of images, again, were taken in mostly sunny conditions. And you can see what we already discussed in the previous examples. There is a contrast and saturation difference between the two images, with the ECN2 appearing flatter, though more natural, in my opinion. I also did a few more prints of some shots taken during the night, and a couple more daytime shots, but I don't want to keep this video going on forever. You can have a look at my blog post, where you can see all the prints that I did, plus I will throw in some close-up examples to help you compare all the prints better, side by side.
Before I wrap up this video, I wanted to share some thoughts on these results. First of all, after reading various deterring comments on printing film developed in ECN2 chemistry, I was happy to find out that although this process is not meant to give you the best print possible, I think the film responded rather well, albeit with lower contrast. And since the C41 version gives you a high contrast result, then I think it opens a world of possibilities where you can pick and choose depending on what you're shooting. Having in mind that the scanned version of the film will look equally good regardless of the developing route you took, then you are left with a creative choice of how you want the printed negative to look like. The ECN-2 has a natural, pleasing look to the eyes that could work well on some subjects. Same goes with the C41 version and the more contrasted look. But more testing is definitely needed, and if you plan to use any of these methods, it will take you some time to create a good workflow from capture to print or scan. To close this video, if you have anything to add, or you feel like I omitted something, or you think something was incorrect in the way the comparison was done, feel free to comment down below. I would also love to hear your opinions on which version did you like best. Did you like the lower contrast look of the ECN-2, or you think it's a complete no-no for you? I'm keen to hear your thoughts. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.